Too much noise. I love it, but you make a lot of noise.
That's very quiet.
Me? Ming, come on, Ming-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling, you're gonna be late for school. Wake up. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. I know you're faking over there. Wake up, I can see your eyes moving. Last chance. One, two, three. That's it. Wake up. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Wake up.
Daddy, why did you do that?
Why did I do that? Because you were faking, that's why, and you're gonna be late. Good morning. How are you?
Fine.
Good. How did you sleep?
Fine.
Good? Okay, good. Now put your slippers on. Then you go into the bathroom and you brush your teeth and you wash your face. And mommy will be here to do your hair. And this is what you're gonna wear, okay?
Yeah.
See you later. High five. Psych.
That's not fair.
Morning.
Morning, baby.
Morning.
What's your name?
Daddy, why are you always hurting Mommy?
Eat your oatmeal.
Mommy's always screaming like you're hurting her.
Eat your oatmeal, baby.
Mommy, you know what? Remember how we go to school in the morning and feed the pigeons and the squirrels?
Yes.
Remember the time the little bird was on the fence, the sparrow, and he was biting that other sparrow on the booty, and I said it's... And the little squirrels with the peanuts were biting each other?
I think so.
Remember I said it was a spring thing?
I remember.
Mating season. Well, baby, that's what your mom and dad are doing. We're making love.
I know. I was just testing if you would tell me the truth.
You knew? You little smarty. You are too smart for your age.
Mommy and Daddy?
Eat your oatmeal.
Are the both of you doing it? Are you doing it? Or are you trying to make a baby?
Eat your oatmeal.
I would like a baby brother.
So you feel full?
Yes.
Yeah.
My oatmeal's filling.
Yeah. How do you like it?
I'm kind of tired of oatmeal.
I hear you. I'm tired of oatmeal myself. You want a
you
good...
never eat it. You never eat your oatmeal.
Yeah, because I'm tired of it. We should have Mommy fix something different.
Yeah, we should tell her tomorrow.
All right. You think that I don't know that you be awake, that you have your door open every morning listening? You're trying to drive me and think that you were asleep. I know what's going on. You know that? Nothing is past me. Okay, baby. Here. I love you so much. Mm-hmm. Have a nice day, okay?
Okay.
All right. Tell Mrs. Jones I said hello. All right?
Bye.
Bye, baby. Could you wait here for a minute?
Sure. Hey, Flip. Good tie, that's on Salma, very sharp.
Thank you, Jerry. Leslie, look, Tony's work here is awful. I mean, he's got this elevator shaft here,
yeah,
6 inches off of where it's supposed to be.
We caught that, Tony. Listen, we have somebody we want you to meet. She comes highly recommended. This is Angela Tucci. She's going to be replacing Terry.
Hi.
What?
She'll be replacing Terry.
Glad to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. I'm looking forward to working.
Well, we explained to the temp service how diligent and hardworking Terry was. Said, give us the best you got. And here she is.
Listen, just call me Angie. I don't like Angela.
Angie it is.
Okay.
You don't have a problem with this, do you, Flip?
No. No.
All right. She's all yours.
Pretty well.
Relatively.
So, your name is Angela Tucci?
Yeah.
You're Italian?
Yeah. What else would I be?
And you don't like to be called Angela?
Look, I mean, Angie's fine, you know? Flip is a nice name. If you don't mind my asking, what kind of name is that?
My father. if you don't mind me asking, how long have you been temping?
Since high school.
And have you ever worked in an architectural firm before?
No, I haven't, but I learn really quick. I like to learn new things. I like to be around new people. I like people.
You like people?
I love people.
Excuse me just a minute.
Okay.
Come on, guys. What is this?
Oh, looks like someone needs a chill pill.
I thought I asked for an African-American to replace Terry.
You requested an Afro-American?
African-American. Jerry, you know I did. I put it in writing.
I didn't see it. You see it?
If you don't like her, you send her back.
Yeah, you tell her you didn't like her performance because she was white.
What? That's not the point.
Remember, she's been here for 5 minutes. Give her a chance. This sounds dangerously like reverse discrimination to me.
What? Leslie, this is not reverse discrimination. Why is it that I'm the only person of color working in this office anyway? Is that discrimination?
Flipper, why should we hire someone solely on the qualification of being an African American? That's not fair.
We hire who we feel is the best human being for the job.
Fine. Miss Angela Tucci it is. But I just want you to know, I hope this works out. Since she likes people.
We're hungry, we're starving.
Hi.
How was your day?
It was good. New job. Fancy. Yeah. Fancy place.
Now, I'm glad they got rid of Strawberry. He was too much fucking trouble. If he wants his ass kissed, let him go to L.A. and let Lasorda kiss him. Now he says he's a born-again Christian. Fuck born again. Play the fucking game.
We're hungry, Angie.
We're starving here, Ranch.
Oh, are you three grown men crippled?
That's a bitch.
Yarms and
come on, Angie, help me. We're just hungry.
Stop. Stay here, Angie, please.
You cook and we'll help you.
Yeah. Help lift your fork to your mouth.
Oh, no, that's plenty. I'm eating like a fucking pig.
Dad, we got a purse at the dinner table.
Sorry, sweetheart. Sorry.
Still eating like a pig.
Now, you guys, I said, thank you, sister.
What?
She works hard all day in Manhattan.
Oh, we don't work,
man. She rushes home. She cooks for us, like your mother used to do. May she rest in peace.
I like mommy's cooking better.
Yeah, so why don't you cook? Yeah, I got a good idea. Jimmy, why don't you cook for the rest of the week? Jimmy's cooking for the rest of the week.
You're smart. What's the matter with you? So you just hear me say you should thank your sister?
Yeah.
You heard me?
Yeah.
Did you understand what I meant when I said you should thank your sister?
I just said it. I was thinking that, and I just said it.
This girl just asked to cook for you. She made a dinner fit for kings, and I like mommy's cooking better.
I know.
Is that nice?
Got no brains.
I want you to apologize to your sister. Son, do what I'm telling you. Apologize to your sister.
Fucking apologize. Don't fucking kick my chair, right? I don't fucking put this glass in your fucking
face. Why don't you apologize?
Shut the fuck up.
Why don't you apologize?
Shut up for 10 minutes.
I was telling the truth. Nobody cooked like my mother cooked, all right?
Not bad. Not
what
bad.
A fucking life.
Just eat. Angie, come on here. Sit down. Come on here, baby. Sit down over here and eat.
You got no class.
World affair you're making it to.
That's it. I had it. Forget about it. I'm done.
Just smack him in the head.
Come and sit down in here, Angela. Come and sit down.
Please, Ange.
Flip.
What's up, Cyrus? You got any gum?
Gum.
Yeah.
Gum, man.
What's up, man?
Doing like 25 miles. Damn. What's up with you?
Hey, brother. I'm just a natural black man trying to survive in a cruel and harsh white corporate America. I know how you do it. I don't know how you do it.
Hey, what's up there, boy? I'm fine, girl. How you doing?
What's Drew up to?
Well, she's downstairs getting ready to cook.
Okay, wait till I give you a call.
All right.
Bye.
See ya.
Come on, go. Let's go downstairs. Oh.
Yeah.
How you doing? What are you staring at?
It's birth control pills and enlarging your breasts.
Yeah, well, did you remember pick up that prescription?
I forgot, I'm sorry.
Oh,
I forgot.
You were supposed to forget?
Well, we have some kids anyway.
Honey, I just got my promotion. A&R is not an easy job to get, and plus, you promised me that you would go back to school for a little while before we had some kids.
That I did.
You make all their money.
They're making all their money. That whole Japanese account is because of me.
Look, they'd be crazy not to do this. Baby?
What?
I want you to be prepared, though, all right?
Prepared for what?
Prepared for if they say no.
If they say no?
Look.
No. They're not going to say no.
I think they'd
be. They have no right to say no.
Totally crazy.
I deserve this.
You do.
I've done everything that they've ever asked me to do. Most of the money that they make in the company is because of me.
Totally.
I deserve this.
You do.
So they're not going to say no.
They better.
You don't even need to think about it.
I'm not.
No negative thoughts, right?
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
Positive thoughts. Positive. I'm so positive. Nobody wants
to come back. Hey, Charlie. I'd like to see your sister Angie. Angie's not home, Paulie. I don't try to be slick and tell me she's not home, because you know when I know that she's washing dishes. I want to see Angie now, please. Come on. Oh, Angie!
What?
It's for you.
Hi, Wally.
Coming out?
Yeah. I'm washing the dishes tonight. The boys are doing them. Charlie's washing, Jimmy's drying.
Yeah.
That's a change of pace.
Let me go.
Huh? Oh, Jimmy! Prince Charming's here, man. Check it out. Oh! Polly! Polly Sawbone. Man. What's up,
Charlie? Hey, Jim. How you doing?
Good.
Good. Look, Polly, we just want to know if you were fucking our sister.
You fucking my sister, Angie?
What kind of question is that?
That's a good question.
It's a stupid question, and I ain't answering it.
Look, Polly, if you're fucking my sister, you better not be, because you get a fucking beat. You know what I'm saying? If we ever hear she's not a virgin anymore, your ass is grass, Polly. You're gonna wish your mother never had you.
If you ever get her pregnant, Polly,
hey,
I don't know why I'm thinking this, because I know it's not gonna happen, but if you did, I'm gonna give you the abortion, Polly. Then you're gonna marry her, okay? Angela's not some slut you find on the street, you know, she's our sister. Don't even think about it, alright?
Polly, don't even think about it!
Guys are sick, you know?
No, we're not sick. You're sick. Look, you look like a bum. What do you got, Louis hand-me-downs on? What is this? Huh?
Oh, Angie! Come out here and talk to this bum before I stop him into the stoop. Oh.
What is this, prom night?
What are you doing?
Finish watching the game, Colin. Just home.
Where you going?
Have some of me.
Where you going? What are you doing? What are you going? 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 What are you
Poor guys, they don't even know.
I know.
Fucking you. That retardation isn't hereditary. Is it? Because it might be.
No, I don't think so.
No, you could be retarded. I'm going out with a retarded girl. Years, I
don't know. Now concerning the things whereof ye wrote unto me, it is good for a man not to touch a woman. Nevertheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife, and every woman have her own husband.
Well, I get it. Let me fix you something to eat, boy. You don't look right.
I look fine.
You been eating?
Like a horse. But I'm not hungry right now. I'll just have a candy bar.
That's not good eating.
It's quick energy. Sugar, glucose, you know?
I'm cooking you something just the same. You don't look like you've been eating regularly. Did I ask you that already?
Mm-hmm.
My mind is getting Are you on that stuff again? You promise?
I promise, Mama. I'm straight. I'm clean. You don't have to worry about me anymore. You rest your heart. That's why I came by here. I got this great new job, but there's only one catch. The application costs $100. Now they say I have a job, but the fee is $100.
You must think you have a fool for a mother.
No, I don't. I think I have a great, understanding, loving, caring mother for a mother.
Foolishness.
I'll pay you back with my first check, with interest. I'm trying, Mama. I'm really trying.
just allow it $100.
Don't take it, Papa.
Lucinda, what is he doing in our home?
But he is your son, our son, our first child, Gator, and I'm fixing him something neat.
He is not allowed in our home.
But this is his home, too.
How much money did they ask you for?
No. Gator did no such thing. Now, why don't you go in there and listen to Mahalia while I get him something neat? Now, go on back inside. Come on. I take care of Gator, honey. You go on back. Gator, dance for me. Do that new move I like. Don't forget to call me here as soon as you get that new job.
Stuff in the morning. I mean, you've done enough hard work for today.
Oh, it's all right. I like to work.
You like to work?
I like to work. Besides, I want my father and brothers to eat McDonald's tonight.
You want your father and brother to eat McDonald's?
See, when I get home, I usually gotta cook for them. And I don't wanna. So I figure if I don't go home, left to their own,
They're grown men. Why are you cooking for them?
Well, yeah, but it's what they expect, because I always do, and so I just think it's time for them to grow up, you know?
Dig it. So, you're a good cook? I mean, you can cook, huh?
Yeah, I can cook. I love to cook.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What? What can you cook?
I can cook anything.
What, spaghetti?
Cook spaghetti.
Lasagna?
Yeah, lasagna. You like lasagna?
I love lasagna.
Oh, yeah. I'll make lasagna for you. What?
You're gonna make lasagna for me.
Yeah, I'll make lasagna. Make it at home and I'll bring it in for you for lunch.
Why don't I just come over to your family's house and eat it with your family?
Well, you could try. I don't know.
It's a joke. It's just... A joke. I'm joking.
I know.
Okay. Shoot, all this talk about food is making me hungry.
Yeah.
Are you hungry?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Bensonhurst.
Bensonhurst? Mm. Nice neighborhood.
Yeah. Where are you from?
Uptown.
In the Bronx?
No. Harlem. Harlem, USA.
Wow.
You ever been there? No? You never been to Harlem?
No, I never met anybody from Harlem. I mean, not Bensonhurst anyway.
Well, you know, you should go. I mean, I think you'd like it. I mean, there's a lot of nice people up there.
Yeah.
You like it?
It's good when you put a lot of soy sauce on.
Yeah, I don't like the soy sauce so much.
What?
What?
What are you looking at? Wait, don't tell me, I know. I know what you're thinking. You're going, wow. Look at your skin color. How dark it is, how. I love your color complexion. I mean, to me, I'm so white, I'm so pale. I get a little sun every now and then when I hang out at Jones Beach, but nothing like that.
I hate the beach. Definitely not a mind reader. I do admit I was looking at your skin.
Boy, it's amazing. You know, this preoccupation with color. I mean, here you are staring at me, and but my experiences, my people, I've been called every black dot, smut, midnight, spot. Every black derogatory name that you could ever think of. And then white people comment all the time. They love it. Deep, dark, tan.
Sorry. It's kind of messed up.
Yeah. It really is.
It's beautiful.
You happy?
We've been going out for a long time, you know, since high school.
So, how does he treat you?
It's all right.
Just all right.
He's a nice guy, you know. He's just, from the neighborhood. It's the kind of thing I'm outgrowing.
Yeah. I'm just saying, I mean, you like all these things, but you're tempting. I mean, I think you could be doing a lot more than that.
Sure.
Positive. So, how long does it take you to get back to Bensonhurst? I've never cheated on my wife before. I mean, I'm married. Happily married.
I know. I kind of figured that.
Wait. Mm-hmm.
Polly, how many daily news did you order?
75.
How many falls?
50.
How many news day?
Papa, I order the same number every day, and every day you ask me the same question.
I gotta know.
You do know, it never changes.
Are you kidding? Newspapers change every day.
Yeah.
Eat your breakfast, okay? Yeah. Call me at lunchtime.
I'll call you at lunchtime. Okay. All right?
Hey. You gonna say goodbye to your mother? Call me at lunchtime.
Call you at lunchtime.
Sure. Running for your life by the night. Running from your wife. Yikes. You should have stuck with home.
Some guy makes up some story? Fuck him. It's a waste of time. Tell me something. Tell me one thing that I don't know that's important from all you're reading.
Right here. I'm reading this story right here.
Yeah, so what?
So, I tell you what. So these Sicilian guys in Louisiana had a factory. It was around 1899. And they gave the black workers equal status in their factory. So the regular white people, they found out about it. And they lynched the five Italian guys who owned the factory. That's so what.
Good. They got what they deserved. They shouldn't have got involved with no niggas in the first place.
It's not the point in the story.
That's my fucking point.
Give me the money, Filato.
Put it on my tabs.
Give me the money. Boy, give me another chocolate cream. It's 5/8 cream you drink.
What is it, Donna got you in a state? I think she's banging the big blonde-headed guy.
You know, one there with the
big blue eyes, the pretty boy.
What's that supposed to mean?
Boy. I'm already telling you.
No, just because I don't look like that. Tall, blonde, blue eyes. That don't mean I don't feel like that.
Yeah.
What am I, some kind of Neanderthal? These fucking Italian girls, man. They're all the same. You know, you think they want their own kind. Nah. What do they want? Fucking Robert Redford they want. Harrison Ford.
They got money, that's right.
Who's that on a wasp? William Hurt. White Anglo-Saxon pricks. Those bums don't know shit about fucking romance.
Guess who's coming now?
Guess who's coming? Boys. What's up?
Hey, what's up? How you doing? Sonny.
Hey, Charlie.
One, Laura.
The usual.
One daily news for your parents and one news day for you.
Everybody else. Have you talked to your father yet?
About what?
About the possibility of getting the Times in here. or the Sunday Times at least.
I did. He says don't sell it, don't order it. Simple as that, supply and demand. So I'll keep trying, though.
Thank you. Here. Oh, I got something for you. I picked up that application from Brooklyn College. It's a lot of information, but don't let that scare you.
Thanks
for remembering. I'll see you later. Bye.
Have a good day.
Enough for a minute, right? See? Now she's a beautiful girl. You see, I was beautiful.
Every morning, same shit.
I don't believe it.
She looks like that Dinah Ross girl.
Paulie, where's my egg cream? Gonna make me egg cream or what? Come on.
She does.
Hey, Paulie, how long we don't sell Ebony and Jet?
Yeah, and we don't get the Amsterdam news either. Like,
you can play copies in
Bed-Stuy. Yeah, Paulie, in fact, why don't you tell her to move over there, you know?
Why don't you guys shut up? We're on good as nice people. You don't know class when you see it.
Ah, yes.
Gentlemen, I think we all know why we're here. My contribution to this company's success and growth speaks for itself. Jerry and Leslie, you know I worked very hard and put in some very, very long hours.
We know that.
We both know that.
And now I think it's time for a vertical move. I have moved as lateral as I can go. And I think the only fair thing to do is to accept me into the position of partner. No, I'm not making any demands. I'm just saying that.
You're not making any demands.
I'm not making any demands. I'm just saying that.
You're asking for a partnership? That's not a demand.
I'm asking what I'm due. I deserve this. I'm the next one in line, and besides, you promised.
We promised in due time.
In due time is what we said.
But fellas, time is due.
Look. We both understand how anxious you are and how patient you've been. But we can't do this now.
Not at this time.
When?
Honestly, I can't say.
You can't say?
Flipper, what is the big deal here? What is this an issue of money, or is it this new secretary you have now?
It has nothing to do with the secretary, and don't patronize.
I am not patronizing.
You know that I work very, very hard.
I work very, very hard, too.
I bust my balls, Jerry.
I bust my balls, too.
Look, I work 7 days a week.
How long have you been with this company, Flipper?
I've been with this company from the very beginning.
What does that say? Mast and Covington.
I helped create that. Matter of fact, that's my design up there.
I set up this goddamn company with...
Still, you can't do this now.
Well, that really disappoints me. I can see that you have no respect for me or my contribution to this company. So you have forced me to turn in my letter of resignation. I can see that I have no future here at Mast and Covington. Gentlemen, have a nice day.
Come on, Flipper, come on. You have to... Don't walk away like this.
There's nothing left to talk about.
Let him go!
Look at this. This is my work. Mine.
You know what your problem is? Your ego's out of control.
Right now. Come on, who's gonna play third base?
I don't give a damn who plays third base.
Look, we spent a long...
Mine!
Mine.
Ego.
Come on, quiet. Come on.
Don't tell me to be quiet.
I'm telling you to be quiet.
This problem.
It's been too. We worked together too long. You know, to end a relationship like this. Now let's just cool down and talk about this. All we're asking for is a little bit more patience.
We don't have any more patience. Fine. If you're that unhappy here, go. Come on. What do I have to do with this? Come on.
Look, I'm really sorry.
So you quit?
I resigned.
Good move. You need to start your own firm. We need our own businesses.
That's exactly what I'm gonna do.
Let me ask you a question. Why are we out here tonight? In this park, late at night?
What's the problem?
Why are we out here tonight, Flipper?
All right, you gotta promise me that you're not gonna tell anybody.
Who am I gonna tell? I don't say nothing to nobody. Nobody.
I nothing. You gotta promise me. I know you, Cyrus.
My lips are sealed. Come on, what happened?
I cheated on Drew for the first time.
You did that? When did this happen?
The other day.
Yeah? I thought you were gonna drop a bomb.
Well, she's white.
White? Man, are you on crack or something? You crazy.
She's Italian.
H-bomb.
From Bensonhurst.
Nuclear megaton bomb. I know you didn't bone her.
Nah.
I know you got better judgment than that.
Right, I
Good.
Do. That's right, no.
Good.
My man.
Good.
That's right, I did it.
Glad you didn't bone him.
Nope. No.
You could have, but you didn't.
Oof. No.
She put it in your face, but you refused. Because you're...
Strong.
You're strong. A strong black man.
Strong black man. Ooh. I threw on the table.
Oh, Flipper, you did. You boned her.
And I was...
You promised. Nuclear holocaust.
Hey, man, it just happened. I mean, it just...
Got a bad feeling about this one. Bad feeling.
So what's so important? I mean, come on, I'm supposed to go out with Vinny tonight. What'd you get us down here for,
What's going on, Angie? You gonna finally have a wedding or what?
No, me and Paul... I don't know.
Yeah, but you're wearing that ring. I mean, come on.
Yeah, and why do you look so happy?
This isn't about
Paul. She's got the glow on her face,
I know.
No, I'm not glowing.
Well, all right, so what is it?
What's going on?
All right. But you gotta swear. I mean, this is like swearing on a stack of Bibles, swearing on like a zillion rosary beads.
I swear on my great-grandmother, okay?
We swear. What?
I'm seeing somebody.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You too, Tyler?
Who are you seeing?
Somebody from work.
That new job.
Yeah.
That was quick.
A very fancy place.
Yeah.
So what's he look like? Who is this guy?
What's his name?
It's a weird name.
Try me.
Flipper?
What kind of name is Flipper?
I know, I told you, it's a weird name, don't laugh.
And what is he, like blonde, blue-eyed surfer type?
Hey, dude.
Right? What is that?
He's black. What's the matter? Is something wrong with your face?
Did it with a black guy?
Yeah.
If your father ever found out, I don't know.
Yeah, well, he's not gonna.
No, of course not. No. Of course not.
No, not from us, even.
But I'm just saying, you know.
That's for sure.
Keep it quiet. I mean, you know, look at Gina.
Gina who?
She brought that guy into the neighborhood, that black guy. Look what they did to him.
Fucking talking about that Puerto Rican crackhead for?
Whatever. I mean, she brought him into the neighborhood, and they killed the guy. You better be careful.
I don't think she's stupid enough to bring him into the neighborhood, Denise.
Well, whatever. I'm just saying, you know. Our lips are sealed.
Personally, I think it's pretty disgusting. Really? Yeah, I think it's gross. I mean, how could... Hey, me, myself, personally, I mean, I could never.
But you're not sleeping with a guy. What do you care if she did it?
I just think she's a beautiful girl. She can have any guy she wants. Why does she have to go with a mooly? I mean, Jesus Christ. I mean...
Hey, look, this is the 90s. There's nothing wrong with it, you know? You having a good time?
I have to admit that I've always been curious about Caucasian women. And it doesn't mean to say that white is right and that sisters aren't beautiful. Sisters are beautiful, too. But, hey, I mean, I was curious, so I just jumped on it.
Literally.
Yes, indeedy. I mean, hey, I mean, that doesn't mean to say that because a brother is with a white girl that he's less down. I mean, less progressive. I mean, I'm still very pro-black.
You're black, all right.
Yes, well, my shit is correct. Very correct.
You got a big problem. You and her. The both of you's got the fever.
The what?
The fever. The both of you's got jungle fever. The both of you's.
That's it, dude. Get some money. We going straight back to that motherfucker. Cut the off. Babe, bro. All right. Come on, baby.
Push
on me. Nigga, don't push on me. Nigga, don't push on me. Nigga, don't step right off into the cash money thing. It's the fifth man. Yo, babe, bruh. Cyrus. Black man. Successful and shit. I want y'all to meet my new woman, Viv. That's short for Vivian. She good people. I like her. I was most fortunate to make her acquaintance most recently. That's my baby brother, Flipper, the one I've been telling you about. Yeah, architect and shit. And that's his main man, Cyrus. He, damn, what is it you do again?
I teach high school.
Damn, that's right, he's a high school teacher and shit. Yeah, hey, I'm sorry, man, you know my mind's getting bad.
I gotta go.
You leaving me?
I gotta go.
You promised.
I promise. My lips are sealed. Vivian, nice to meet you. Gator. Peace, two fingers.
Peace. Yo, Viv, would you let two loving brothers get a moment alone to get reacquainted and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Where the fuck am I supposed to go? I don't know where the fuck I am.
Where the fuck were you going? Okay, skinny ass fucking motherfucker. I'm getting motherfucking swing away from me.
Swing, motherfucker, that's coming.
What? Come on, you can do me this one solid. What? Well, would you rather I go out and rob some elderly person? Steal? Well, either way, I'm gonna get high. Look, I really hate having to resort to knocking elderly people in the head for their money. But I'll do it. You know I'll do it. You know I'll do it. I like getting high. I'm a crackhead. Ow. I like to get high. I'm a crackhead. My brother. Yeah. Yo, Bill.
We're not doing this anymore.
Come on, let's go. Hit me over there.
That's it, Gator. That's it.
Okay, ladies, so we have one.
one chicken livers and onions with candied yams and collard greens. And one Sylvia's world famous talked about barbecue rib special. Potato salad and black eyed peas. Two iced teas. Can I get you anything else?
No.
I should have done this a long time ago. Break away and start my own business. You still gonna work at Maston and Covington?
I'm the temp secretary, remember?
Damn it! Excuse me, miss. Miss. May we order, please?
Yes, may I take your order?
Is this your station?
Yes, this is my station. Unfortunately.
Look, you can take my order. Matter of fact, you could have taken my order 30 minutes ago when I sat my black ass in
this
chair.
Can I take your order?
Excuse me. Do you have a problem?
Yes, I do have a problem, to be honest with you. Fake, tired brothers like you coming in here, that's so typical. I can't even believe you brought her stringy hair ass up here to eat.
Oh, let me tell you something. First of all, Miss Al Sharpton, you don't have... It's not your business who I bring in here. It's not your business. You are a waitress. Your job is to wait.
Today's specials are Maryland crab cakes, Creole shrimp gumbo, and blackened catfish. I suggest you have the blackened catfish.
Well, I suggest you find the manager.
Oh, you want my manager?
I want your manager.
Oh, it's like that, right?
That's the other
one. Right, fine,
I want
fine,
the manager.
Fine. You get my, I'll get my manager for you.
You're fired!
You're tired.
She's right.
I love her, you know? She's great. We have a great marriage, a great daughter.
What's she do?
She's a buyer for Bloomingdale's.
So, what are we doing?
Honestly, don't know.
It was like spit.
I mean, I guess I don't expect you to leave her.
Well, I'm not.
So then, what are we doing? Because I don't think we're just fooling around. All right. Is it true that black men don't like to go down on women? Come on, you heard that, right?
No,
don't tell me you didn't hear
that. No, no, no. Untruth, untruth, untruth. That's just like white boys have little mini frosted Wheaties dicks.
What? Is that true? It's not true.
I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know.
It's not true. It's not. It's a myth. I think.
Between us. we can talk this out. I know. We can talk this out.
You don't have to answer your father. I know you and Drew will work this out.
Was it the temptation or the sweet nectar of another woman's fruit? Devil is always at work.
People are responsible for their own actions, Dad. The devil had little, if anything, to do with it.
It was thinking like that led you from the straight and narrow.
Do you ever just talk? Let him who is without sin cast the first stone. Straight and narrow? Not you. Not me, and definitely not you. You and me come from the same crooked straits.
Now that's the end of this conversation. Go get your wife back. You both need each other. And Ming needs the both of you. Please, now let's eat this meal in peace.
Ain't nothing but a low-class, white trash. She probably didn't even finish high school.
Girl, you know that's the truth.
That's what he left me for.
See, I always thought Flipper was the ideal husband. Girl, you can never tell. They are all dogs. I promise you, they're all dogs.
Y'all know what? We're gonna have to start dating white men.
Stop it, Joe.
I'm not.
No, it's true.
I'm not dating no white
men. It ain't no good black men out there.
Oh, yes, there are no good. Most of them are drug addicts, in jail, homos. The good ones know they just shit. So they got 10 women at a time, leaving babies all over the place.
My marriage is wrecked.
It's fucked up. The man is gone. He's fucking some white bitch, and I still believe there's good black men out there.
Where? And the options? What are the options?
You know what the options are? Be gay. Or see somebody who likes you no matter what, Chinese, black, white, or whatever.
Wrong, Elder. You're wrong as the day is long. They're out there. The problem is we're looking in the wrong places.
We're looking someplace. I don't know where we're looking, but we're not looking at bus drivers or truck drivers or garbage men, and a lot of them are doing that, and we just won't give them the time of day. But they're good men.
How many men do you know, black men, who can effectively deal with a mate who has more education and makes more money? Not many. They freak, and y'all know I'm telling the truth.
I know, girl. No, yes, the fact remains is that we are losing our men. That's the bottom line. A lot of this doesn't really so much have to do with the black men. I know it does, and I know we want to blame them, and it is their blame. But part of it is that these white bitches throw themselves at black men. Do you see the way they look at them? You can't walk down the street with your man without 29,000 white bitches coming on to him, and they will give up the pussy because their fathers tried to keep it from them all their lives. When they turn 18 and they leave home, they're going to get that black dick. Yeah. They're going to get it. They're going to get it. And it can be yours, 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 or mine, and they want it. And they're getting it.
Deal with the black man for a minute.
Oh, Inez.
There's a lot of self-hate going on when he can't deal with a sister.
Yeah, but Inez, how would you know? You won't deal with a black man. How would you know?
Oh, no. I do date black men, but I also date Chinese, Latino, Jewish, the full spectrum.
That's not really a consolation for this particular
argument.
Well,
it's not supposed to be.
Oh,
all I'm saying is I know you think I should date black men, but I'm going to date who I like. Give me a man, regardless of the color of his skin, who is nice to me,
who is sweet to me and who I strongly believe loves me.
It's not about me.
I am not the rainbow fucking kind.
Yes, you are the reading rainbow. We know this about you. Drew, if it'll make you happy, honey, I will make a pilgrimage to Africa, the motherland, and find myself a true tribesman.
A true Asiatic black man.
With a dick down to his knees to keep me happy for days.
Oh, Zulu dick!
That's right, girl. Give me some serious Zulu dick in the bush.
Oh. Like
do any of you know what it is like not being thought of as attractive?
I can't believe you ever believed that.
Drew, it's the kind of shit you buy into, okay? I was always the darkest one in my class, and I know you know what I'm talking about. All the guys ran after the light-skinned girls with long, straight hair, and that left me out. And it's that same kind of thinking that leaves us out when it comes to white women. Now, back in the day, brothers would get sisters that looked like you, Drew, and you, Vera, you know? But now, light skin ain't even good enough. Today, brothers are going for the gusto. I mean, the real McCoy. That's why Flipper's gone. White girls got it made.
This, the whole thing, everything that we've been doing, and everything in the society, we just keep on doing the same thing over and over.
Yes.
Keep on telling ourselves, negating ourselves, our own value. Look at the brothers who are successful. Look at them. Most of the brothers who have made it got white women on their arms. Okay? In order to go up that little ladder to success, seems like you got to have Miss Thing on your arm.
Their responsibility level isn't the same as ours.
It's not a question of responsibility. It's just a fundamental disrespect.
Disrespect
for women.
God. I mean, I don't care. The best man. It's hard for him to say no. Some pussy stared him in the face. I'm sorry. I don't know the man that's been born that's going to say no to... Here, look around. Ain't nobody looking. He gonna fuck the pussy.
Okay.
If you want to commit a relationship, then you are supposed to be able to say no. It's the art of no theory for me. Okay. If you know that you're involved with this person, you have no business. And I don't believe. I know that there's such thing as. I mean, you're gonna get turned on and all that. You're gonna see somebody you wanna fuck, but your mind's supposed to tell you, I have a committed relationship
That's
here.
Right.
I have a
That's
wife.
Right.
I have whatever. Tell the dick to shut the fuck up. Tell the dick
to
get
down.
Strap that fuck up. You know what?
You have to. You know something, though? It don't even matter what color she is. My man is gone.
Nah, Flipper. Nah. I want to talk to Drew. There's a war council going on in your living room. Where's me? Asleep upstairs with us. Let's take a walk.
How did Drew bust me? Don't tell me it was because you opened your big mouth. God damn, see, I trusted you. See what happens?
I can't tell my wife. Who can I tell?
Nobody, 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 nobody. I told you, don't tell a soul. You promised me. What are you, 411 or something?
How was I supposed to know? Viewers are gonna run back and tell Drew. I didn't know that shit.
Use your better judgment. That's how. She is a woman. All women stick together. They always do and always will. Now I'm thrown out of my house because of your silly, no keeping a secret, married to a blabbermouth wife.
Don't talk about my wife. You need a place to stay. You can stay with us as long as you want to say the word, but don't talk about my wife.
And be spied on all night? Yeah, I'd rather live with the FBI and the CIA. She would be giving an on-the-hour report of everything I did to Drew. Miss Big Mouth!
Hey, did a Big Mouth say go fuck that lady? He had nothing to do with that shit. So put the fucking blame on the blamey. You, not me. That's right, why are you laughing?
Cause you fucked me up, that's why I'm laughing.
I mean that shit.
You got a place to
stay. So your marriage fucked up, man.
Oh,
I didn't mean
fuck
it.
Fuck you.
I didn't mean it. It was a mistake. You're right, I shouldn't have told her. She's a big fucking...
Eventually go get yourself a white girl, didn't you?
What do you mean eventually?
What I mean is you got a complex about color. You've always had it. I never wanted to believe it until now. Only girls you've ever dated has been light-skinned girls. You and Cyrus, both of you, both of you.
Well, you don't know what type of women I dated before we got together. And that's not the issue here.
The issue is it's because you're so black you have a problem.
Oh, that's insane. That's insane.
I've told you what happened to me when I was growing up. I've explained to you. I poured my heart out. I told you how they called me high yellow, yellow bitch, white honky, honky white, white nigga, nigga white, octoroon, quadroon, half-breed, mongrel. And what do? Do you love this girl?
Oh, Drew, you gotta be kidding me.
You gotta be kidding me.
I love you.
Do you love her?
No, I don't.
I'm so glad for you. So glad. Because don't you know white people hate black people because they're not black? They can't relate.
Now, Drew, did your white father hate your black mother?
You're talking about my family.
See, this is what I'm saying to you. Color's got you fucked up, too.
Maybe it has. Maybe that's why this hurts me so much. Can't you see that? I trusted you. And I loved you.
And you still do.
Oh, please. Don't tell me what I feel. I don't. And I won't again. You can take your little tired ass roses and just get the fuck out of my place of business.
Love can be so insecure. So please be
Sit down. for a long time, Polly.
Yeah.
Look, Polly, I care about you too much to bullshit you. But, I need to get away from here as far as possible. I want to get out of here.
I don't understand. What, are you moving or something? This is about something else. Is there anything else that you want to tell us? Some skirt.
Not some skirt, it's Angie. She's a woman.
You call that a woman? I was married to a real woman, your mother.
That
was a woman.
I wanted to marry Angie.
She did you a big favor. Marriage to her would have been hell. Besides, marriage to her is a joke. People get married, divorced, married. All they think marriage is for is humping. They don't know their duties.
What duties?
Wifely duties. Those kind of women are rare. Your mother and me, we had our wars. She didn't talk to me for almost 2 years. Not a word. Still, she scrubbed my back. Never stopped doing her duties. That woman was there for me till death do us part. That was a fucking marriage. Sometimes when I'm alone, she says to me, "Go kiss me." But I try, but I can't find her lips.
When was the last time? School for 8 years. 8 years.
That's 16 years, you moron. It's a fucking mister.
You gonna give her a beating?
My father did that already.
I'm not talking about a father, I'm talking about you.
Yeah, he ain't talking about Mike, he's talking about you, Paul.
You see my girl Denise? She knows better. She got out of line one time, I stomped her right in the midsection.
Morning, Polly.
Speak in a second.
And the mozzarella.
I do it too. But I won't let anybody see us together. No way I walked out of 18th Avenue with a black Atlanta. No fucking way.
Yeah, not even Paula Abdul.
Not even Paula Abdul.
Hey, Paula Abdul says she's not black.
Paula Abdul? Who's Paula Abdul? She got big tits? It's gotta stop somewhere. Next thing a black guy would want to pork Denise. Come on. They took over sports. Baseball. Basketball, football, boxing. What do we got left? Hockey?
Golf.
Golf. Come on, man. They fucking elected Dinkins. Jesus Christ. When does it stop?
I don't need this shit from you guys today. All you ever do is complain, man. Complain. When Dinkins won, the next day everybody was packing up, leaving New York. And where did you guys go? Around the corner?
What's the first thing he does? He appoints that black police commissioner, right? What's his name?
Brown, Lee Brown.
Downtown Brown.
Hey, Vinny, did you vote?
No, I didn't vote. I had to fix my car.
Patty, did you vote?
No, I had to help my moms out, all right?
Are you sure?
Yeah, I voted.
You didn't vote.
I didn't vote.
I did vote.
Fuck you.
Oh, shit. Frankie Bob.
Should I vote? I voted about six times. I wrote Rudy. No, I put a stamp on it. I don't know if they got it.
ML.
Yeah.
Shit. Fucking fluent.
Sonny, did you vote?
I went to PS205 over here. That must have moved. I'm not going to walk around all day.
You guys didn't even register to vote. You never voted in your whole life. No wonder Giuliani lost.
Now, what's the sense of voting, Paulie? Look at Marion Barry smoking crack in his hotel room with his girlfriend. I mean, the mayor of D.C., the nation's capital.
What does that have to do with David Dinkins? It's two different people.
He's black!
Then there's Marion Barry, and then there's David Dinkins.
Black on black.
David Dinkins, Marion Barry.
Black on black.
And he's talking about Dinkin' Donuts.
Anyway, you add it up, 1 + 1, it's 2. Two different people.
Yeah, but they're both black. Read the Post, Paulie.
I sell the Post.
What about Central Park?
Yeah, Salon Baloney.
Fucking guy writes a rap poem, he says he's innocent. He's not remorseful one bit.
What the fuck was that? I'm a cool type of fellow, cool, calm, and mellow. Get the fuck out of here.
I'm talking about Central Park. I'm not talking about
Central
Park.
What are you talking about? Let me ask you something, Paulie. Did you vote?
Did I vote?
Yeah.
Did I vote?
Did you vote, Paulie?
I voted.
Who'd you vote?
That's my business.
Your business, huh? He probably voted for Dinkins.
Yeah, the guy who likes tennis. It was a very good year.
It's small. See, and the rent is an arm and a leg. You expect it?
Oh, yeah. I always wanted a building.
Oh, you did?
Mm.
Well, here it is. The humble residence of two outcasts.
I'm here to see my younger brother. I'm his older brother, Gator. Hey.
Hi. Angela.
Nice to meet you.
Well then.
Thanks.
How you doing?
Good.
Good. All right. Flipper.
Yeah.
Brother.
Hey. Okay. I'm gonna go unpack.
What the fuck are you doing here? Huh? How'd you find out this address? What, Cyrus gave it to me?
She's white. No shit, yeah, she's white. She got any money? Real
money? No, she doesn't have any money. She's a temp.
A secretary?
You mean to say my little brother got him a old fade who ain't got no money? Who am I true? Me. Get this complex, man. And see, me, myself, personally, I would have opted for some money and shit. You know what I'm saying? But I got to give you some dap. She looks good. See, most brothers with white bitches, 9 out of 10, they don't never have them no penthouse pet. Most brothers be having them an outhouse pet. A dog, flies, fleas. See, but that don't work for the white boy, see. If a sister is on his arm, I guarantee you she be slamming. Boom! Pow!
Alright, alright. Well, what is it that you want, huh?
You sure she ain't got no money? I mean, she could be fronting, you know what I'm saying? Perpetrating on the green. She Jewish, right?
No, she's Italian.
Oh, shit!
You always had to do things the hard way.
Oh, look at here. I'm a little light, though. I'm not alone.
What, you didn't get your check from Soul Train yet?
You know, Don lost my address. Come on, hit me. Get some cash in my hand.
Come on, door hit you with a gun.
Oh, come on, man, give me some money. Now I'll be bossing. Come on, don't do me like this, man.
I'm not giving you anything, okay? Gator?
I'll tell you what.
No.
Let me go back and ask the bitch.
Don't call her a bitch. She's not a bitch.
Okay, I didn't mean that.
Okay, all right. Thank you. Now, I apologize and get the fuck out.
You okay?
I should go and see my little girl.
Daddy!
Hey! Come here! Hey, look what I've got. Yes, she is.
Daddy, Mommy takes me the wrong way to school every day.
She does?
Yeah.
Well, Ming-a-ling, there's more than one way to go to school.
Well, I still like our way, Daddy.
That's your mother. She's the loud one who wakes up all of Harlem.
It doesn't bother me. I wish your mommy would be back together making those funny noises in the morning. You coming home?
Go ask your mother.
I did already. She told me to ask you.
Well, your father says to go and ask your mother.
I just did.
I suck your dick good for $5, baby.
You what?
$5, Daddy. Come on, I suck your dick.
Now you listen to me. If I ever see you using drugs, I'll kill you. You understand that?
I didn't do anything.
My dear, are you a Catholic?
Well, yeah, I went to Catholic school my whole life, so I guess I am by now.
In this house, we're Baptists.
Yes, the good Reverend Doctor was the head of his own flock.
The Hard Rock Baptist Church.
The devil and his cohorts conspired to oust me from my congregation.
Now, Daddy, you know the devil ain't have nothing to do with it. It was you. You and your stubbornness, that's all it was.
For it must needs be that offenses come into the world, but woe unto him by whom the offense cometh. I recognize the devil's handiwork when I see it.
That's good. Please, let's not argue at the dinner table. Flipper, have you met Angie's folks?
Not as of yet.
Well, my mother passed away, and my father, he's asked me to leave.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all right. I just don't think we'll be having dinner there soon.
Well, has Flipper told you about his loving wife and daughter?
Yes, yes.
Excuse me.
You think I don't understand about the white woman committing black adultery, but I do.
Now, Daddy, no sermons, please.
You see, there was a lot of lynchings down in Willacoochee, Georgia, where I come from, when I was a boy.
Willacoochee, Georgia. What a name.
White man say to his woman, baby, you are the flower of white southern womanhood, too holy and pure to be touched by any man, including me. I'm gonna put you up on a pedestal so the whole world fall down and worship you. And if any nigger so much as look at you, I'll lynch his ass. She believed him, thought she really was holy and pure like the Virgin Mary. She let him put her up on that pedestal. Meanwhile, the husband, no sooner than the sun went down, down to the slave quarters, grabbing up every piece of black poontang he could lay his hands on, then running to the gin mill to brag about it. And that's how our blood got diluted. Mulattoes, quadroons, octoroons. I'm sure that most of those high and mighty white ladies felt abandoned, but they were so proud to be white and therefore superior. They kept their mouths shut and their legs locked tight. But in the midnight hour, laying there alone on the hot bed of lust, I'm sure they must have thought what it would be like to have one of them big black bucks their husbands were so desperately afraid of. I feel sorry for you. Here it is, the night is still trying to make up for what you missed out on. But I don't blame you. As for the black man, like my own son Flipper, who ought to know better, got a loving wife and daughter, still got to fish in the white man's cesspool, I have nothing but contempt. Excuse me. I don't eat with whoremongers.
But you knew she was coming.
That's all right, Mama. That's all right. It's all right. Angie, we're leaving.
Let's go. Mama, I'm sorry.
But you invited them.
Coming out?
to Omega, two rough brothers.
Well, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, who do you think taught Mike Tyson, huh?
Gus D'Amato.
Gus D'Amato? Yeah, right, but when he died, I told him everything he knows.
Oh, yeah?
Uh-huh, that's right.
Yeah, right.
You wouldn't hit me with glasses, would you?
Yes, I would.
You would?
All those good Italian boxes there are. Graziano. Yeah, Marziano. Come on, LaMotta.
LaMotta?
Yeah.
Now, how's that? What about Muhammad Ali, huh?
Hey, Ali.
What?
Ali was a Muslim and preached hate all the white people.
I'll kill you if you ever talk about Muhammad Ali.
You can't. You're a witch. You're a witch. I'll never stand for nobody to talk about the greatest Muhammad Ali. That's the one. I can't take witch. Okay, look. Game on. Game on. Give me my glasses. Let me have my glasses.
Why don't you say please?
I'm not gonna say please. That's not gonna stop me from being angry. Put him up, I said. Get your hands up. Get your hands up.
Back away.
Get your hands up now.
Get back.
Move.
Please separate yourself.
To the wall. Against the wall, man. Against the wall.
Let go of me. That's my boyfriend.
Get back.
That's my lover. What are you doing?
Officers, she doesn't know what she's talking about. He wasn't trying to rape you!
Assault you!
No.
What? You sure?
Yes,
I didn't do anything!
Take the fucking gun from his head!
Talk to me, man! What?
This is just a big misunderstanding, that's all it is.
Slow. Turn around. Slow.
I was just making sure she got home safe, that's all I was doing.
All right. Look, sorry about that. No harm, no foul. It's just that we got a call that an Afro-American male was attacking a Caucasian woman.
You all right, man? Just a little excited.
What?
No problem. What?
Come on.
What?
Don't you dare try it!
Next time, man. Excuse
me. What are you, crazy?
Listen, you need to take it easy, all right?
I have your badge number. I will bring you up on charges.
Shut up.
You can be sure that I'm a torturer.
Shut up. What's the matter with you, huh? What are you doing telling them we're lovers? You're trying to get me killed.
It's none of their business what we do.
What a waste.
What the fuck am I doing here?
Morning, Polly.
Morning.
How are you today?
Good.
See you later.
Excuse me, please. Your majesty. I sense a small but nervously.
What?
Yeah.
A
fantasy.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah. Did you fill out that application?
Oh, no, not yet.
Polly.
I'm gonna get to it.
Uh-huh.
Listen, I... Do you think you could be attracted to a white boy?
A white boy? Could this white boy be Polly Carbone?
Possibly, yeah.
I don't know. Maybe. I would have to think about it.
Well, why don't you think about it?
Okay, but can I be honest with you? I have never thought of you in that way. I'm sorry.
I like you.
You're serious? Why? Why me?
You wanna know? You wanna know?
Yeah, sure. I really wanna know.
What? You're intelligent? I find you very, very attractive.
Well, thank you. That's nice. It's sweet. But right now, I gotta get to work, and I have a class later. Polly, I gotta go. Bye.
Remember, think about it on the way to the subway.
Yeah, right.
Your brain out.
Oh, why are you trying to wrap them as Goody?
Good.
Good, whatever. Doesn't even talk to us.
Yeah, who does she think she is?
And Warren talks to whoever talks to her.
She said good morning to me one time.
Boy, did you fuck her? Did you fuck her? You know, colored women, they like to fuck.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, they're built that way. I mean, you put a saddle on that man, you ride them into the sunset, man. I'm telling you, they love it. They love it.
How do you know?
Yes, his mother. Oh. Hey, what the fuck's that supposed to mean? My mother's not black. She's just dark. They were dark Italians.
Come on, Frankie Box.
Hey, I'm as white as anybody in here.
Okay, Frankie Box, relax. We're just busting your balls.
At least my brother ain't no crackhead.
Hey, Frankie. Hey, Tony ain't no crackhead. He's on methadone.
Fucking drug addict.
He's a recovering heroin addict on methadone. So fuck you.
Fuck me?
Yeah.
Fuck you.
Hey, come on. Don't talk about my fucking brother.
Frankie Box. Your brother's a fucking thief, man. He stole a radio out of my fucking car.
How do you know?
Hey. How do I know? He fucking tried to sell it back to me, man.
Either you're doing it or you're not doing it. And you're not doing it, pal.
You're just jealous because she speaks to me every morning.
Yeah, we're dying of envy over here, Paulie.
Hey, Paulie, you seen Angie lately?
Hey, you miss her, right, Paulie?
Hey, Paulie, I heard she's living in Harlem now. I saw her buying a Kangaroo.
Yeah, she got a pair of unlaced Jordans, too.
You got a big mouth. Shut your mouth, you understand?
Come on.
Don't you let her eat your fucking tape up to you.
Get out of here.
I'll bury you, you fuck.
Okay, Mom, it's all right. It's all right.
I don't know what's wrong with Gator. I prayed so much for that boy. He's gonna give me a heart condition.
What did he do now?
Gator left just before you got here. Came over here wanting to borrow the color TV.
For what?
Said he wanted to watch the Mets. He couldn't pitch. I told him he couldn't watch the game over here because the good Reverend Doctor would be back soon and would raise holy hell if he saw him in this house.
So what happened then, Mom?
He got mad, unplugged the TV, picked it up, just walked on out of here. Said he'd bring it back after the game.
Look, Mama, listen. Just Mama, you can forget about the TV. And you should also forget about Gator. But Mama, in the end, he's only gonna break your heart.
Hush your foolishness. And Lord knows I raised you to the best I know how. Gator is your oldest brother, me and your father's first child.
Mama, your first child is a crackhead.
Don't say that.
It's the truth.
You mustn't say that about your brother.
But Mama,
he is not a crackhead.
Mama, it's not your fault. It's not my fault. It's not the good Reverend Doctor's fault. And listen, it ain't got nothing to do with the devil.
I want you to find him and get the TV back before your father comes back home.
Mama, please, please listen to me. Forget about the TV. Okay.
I don't want to hear any back talk, not another word. Do as I say. Find your brother and get the good Reverend Doctor's TV back. Love you.
In all thy ways acknowledge the Lord and
day for me. What's up, man? What's up? Look, you seen Gator?
No, I haven't seen him.
He hasn't passed by here.
How can I know him? I see him, I let him know you're looking for him.
All right. All right. Peace out. Taj Mahal, that's the name of
it? Yeah.
Yeah, that's where he's at, man. This is Taj Mahal.
What's the Taj Mahal?
The Taj Mahal is, it's like the Trump Towers for crack dens around here. Alright? That's where your brother's at, man. He's a basic B. Sorry.
Where's it at?
It's up on 145th and Convent.
Thank you.
Hey, whatever.
Gator.
Yeah.
Hey! Welcome to the Taj Mahal, eighth wonder of the world.
Gator, mama wants to know where the TV is.
You know the mess lost. There's some sorry motherfuckers. Half of them can't play good as mama.
Where's the TV, Gator?
What do you think the motherfucking color TV is? It's right here. Me and Bill smoking the fucking color TV. Sony! No baloney. Joke. Mama is crying her eyes out over your sorry black ass. Look, I like getting high. Why you think I got a room here to charge my all? I'm a junkie. Crackhead. Just tell Mama her oldest son is a crackhead.
Fine, that's it. That's it. We're cutting you off, Gator.
Don't come by the good Reverend Doctor's house anymore. Don't ever ask me for shit. If you want to go out like this, you fine. You do it with your crack hole.
Crack hole!
Crack hole!
Eat me, motherfucker!
Fuck you!
Take your box ass!
Get off of me, man!
Get out of here, motherfucker!
That's right, get the fuck off my way! I'll shoot you, Mickey! I'll shoot you! Bitch, you!
You gotta get out of my way!
You!
Shut, leave me alone! Leave me alone! Are you cracking?
Together now. I don't know. You don't know. Who the fuck knows?
Is that the way it is?
That's the way it is.
What about children?
No, that's not gonna happen.
I'm saying if we work it out.
No children. Babies. Besides, see, I gotta be married to have children. Or have you already forgotten that I already am married? With a child. No, half black, half white babies for me. No.
Aren't you Vera Mulatto's? The skin is lighter than mine.
No octoroon, quadroon, mulatto babies, no.
Don't you have a daughter who's got white blood in her?
Yeah, so what? Look, at least in my eyes, Drew and Ming are black. They look black, they act black, so they are black. And it's hard enough just being black out here. No. A lot of times the mixed kids, they come out all mixed up, bunch of mixed nuts. No.
No, you're not that much different than my family.
Yeah, well, your family is racist.
What is the stuff you're talking now?
And
Angie? Some shit.
Would you like me to tell you what happened? I still care about you, Paulie. How you feel?
How you expect me to feel? I don't feel the same. Angie, I gotta go. Nice to see you back in the neighborhood.
Sugar home to this house. God, your mother was alive. She turned over in her grave.
Papa, I'm going out.
You are not going out.
I'm going out.
I'll kick your balls right through your throat.
Pa, I got no life, you understand? I got nothing, man. Everything I do is for you. Paulie, do this. Paulie, do that. Paulie, wash my back. Paulie, what's for dinner? Paulie, how many posters did you sell today? I'm not your fucking wife! I'm your son! Life. You had your life! I want a life, man! You had yours!
Be brave, young lover.
You hate me.
And follow your soul.
You hate me. Your own father. I don't hate you. I like to kill you, but I don't hate you. You are not my son! You are not my son!
Whoa! Damn!
Take it easy.
You're not
my son.
Come on, relax.
Take it easy.
What's your matter?
Where you going,
Paulie,
huh?
Paulie, what you burning
yourself
for,
Paulie,
huh?
Paulie,
who's the lucky girl?
Hey, you look pretty, Mr. Paulie. Yeah? You don't want to have that fucking nigger?
Patty.
You think you're better than me, Paulie? Huh? Paulie, huh? You're a fucking disgrace to the stable. You're a fucking disgrace, an asshole. You know better than me.
You know what they say?
Where's your books, Paulie, huh? Where's your books, huh?
Don't cry because I'm alone.
I learned.
What happened to you?
I fell over some garbage.
Come on in. You look terrible.
I had a love of my own.
to give up. It's not worth it.
No.
I mean, it's not worth it. I don't love you. And I doubt seriously if you've ever loved me.
Don't tell me what I felt or didn't feel.
Look, Angie, this love will overcome everything is in Walt Disney films. I've always hated Disney films.
I didn't come here to talk about Snow White.
You got with me despite your family, because you were curious about Black.
Is that what you think it was?
Yeah, I do. And I was curious about White.
Okay, that guy just came to say, I hope everything works out with your wife.
Yeah. Angie, hold on a second. You gonna be all right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm moving out of here in the morning. I mean, you can have it if you want it.
It's okay. Okay.
Walk that goddamn barking rat of his. Hurry up, old man. Just keep walking. Just keep walking. Here we go. Showtime.
I save a lot of money. mine. I'm not giving you a red cent. And what happened to your father's color TV?
Mama, I smoked the TV.
Lord have mercy on your twisted soul.
I ain't going nowhere. Do you give me some money?
I don't have any money.
Well, what about some jewelry?
These pearls aren't real. This costume jewelry.
Well, give me some.
Leave, boy. Go before your father gets back in this house. Just stop! Let go of your mother's pocketbook!
Stay away from me, Mama! I need some money, I'm sick!
If you're sick, why don't you go someplace and lie down? Please!
What is all this shit? Where's the money? Why are you tripping like this? Why don't you just give me the money?
I told you, honey, you won't find no money in that pocketbook. I haven't got any money. Not the kind of money you're looking for.
$20? Is that all the money you got?
Oh, my God.
$20 ain't shit.
For the love of sweet Jesus, please go.
Boy, didn't I tell you never to set foot in my house again?
Where's the money? Why are you hiding?
Have you lost your natural mind as well as your soul? Didn't I tell you never to darken my door again?
No, Gators, leave it. He's got
money. I ain't going nowhere.
All right. I'll put you out.
See, Mama, if you gave her the money, I'd have been gone before he came back. Now give me some money.
God knows, Gator. If I had any money, I'd give it to you.
You got money in this house. Mama, give it to me.
This is how you want. Take it, honey.
You got more money than
$20? Look at it. You see this? You can sell it. You can get money.
I don't want that shit. I want some money.
My own flesh and blood, my firstborn son, and I love you. But you're evil and you're better off dead.
All right. Leave!
Devil's work is never done. The devil is always busy.
Mama, check out this new step. I made this one up just for you.
I paid a lot of money for these, honey. Take them. Sell it, for God's sake, please go.
I pray for you, my son. Father, I stretch my hands to thee.
Thank you.
$2.
As the good and man expires. legacy we have taken from Earth for so many ages. Will there be a time where taking stops and giving starts? Yes, we're feeding all the love of the land, never hearing what he's saying, living off the love of the Lord, never feeling what you're praying, never praising him for beauty.